What's up, everybody, and welcome to Westland Survival. So I am finally back from doing my dissertation. I'm no longer off in Scotland, so I thought to celebrate that I'd start out a new game on the channel. So this is, as I've already said, it's Westland Survival, and as you can see, it's a Last Day on Earth similarly typed game. However, this one is entirely westerny themed, and it's got some nice western music in the background as well. I like this music. Oh yeah, and it's replaced zombies with just wild animal-y things. I really like it. Alright, let's go over here. I've already played through this a bit and I got to about level 15 whilst I was away, so I kind of know what I'm doing, which is always good. Hey, there we go. Let's put on some clothes and let's take a knife. There we go. Perfect. What else have we got in here? And 3 bits of corn. There we go. Awesome. Right, now let's try and sneak up on this coyote over here. Dead. Okay, so we've got coyotes and hares. Oh, there we go. And a couple of ragamuffins. So these are what would be zombies. There's a few different types of just wandering enemies. There's, what have we got? I think there's ragamuffins, hobos, and I can't remember the others off the top of my head. Where's this plant? Oh, there it is. That was really well hidden. Right, now, I'm completely unable to find any stones. Okay, I've got one stone now. I thought there'd be more. Right. So yeah, what I really like about this game is it's just, whilst it's similar to Last Day on Earth in the building and exploring aspects of the game, it is really different. I really enjoy the western theme of it. So if anyone hasn't tried it out already, I would definitely recommend it. And we've also, I've helped open up the official Discord for the game. So the link for the Discord will be in the description below if you want to come and join the official Discord. Hey. Right, so at the moment, yeah, as you can tell, I'm just kind of like trying to chop down trees, get everything I need to build a little base. What I'm tempted to do... Ooh, level up. Okay, so this is where the game gets interesting. When you level up, you get more health, so your health goes over 100. Also, there's these 4 attributes down here. Damage, attack speed, defense, and spirit. And you can put 1 point into one of these every time you level up. So what I want to do is level up spirit, because once you get to 5 spirit points, you can actually control a coyote, and it'll run around for you like a true friend dog when you're in a zone. And it'll, help kill things, which is really cool. Right, I think what I'm going to do is try and clear out this top corner and try and build my base entirely in this top section and keep a bunch of trees still growing because I like it. Right, let's, how can I zoom out? Okay, I don't think I can zoom out. No, I can't. Right, so we've got a nice foresty bit down there. Okay, so there isn't actually that much left to chop down anyway, so there's not really any point. This heat is crazy, it never lets up, day and night. How unfortunate. Hey, die, coyote. Right, you know what, I'm just going to try and find the rough centre of the area. So let's go, say, in 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so I'm saying there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so it's 17 long. You know what? Let's just put our center tile there. There we go. And let's start out with a, whatever the shape this is. Perfect. Right, now, can I build any form of storage or backpack type things? Here we go, shoulder bag. Excellent. Now, can I just craft this straight away? Yes. And there we go. We've got an extra slot in our inventory now. Now in a small box. Perfect. Oops. And let's craft one of these as well. And let's do that and that. Beautiful. Look at that. Right. In the small box go these things. Just bits that I know I won't use for now. Right. Now, what am I going to need? A few more bits of wood. So then I can get a pickaxe going and start farming a little bit of stone. Oh yeah, I can't believe I haven't said this already. Whilst I was away, I hit 9,000 subs. And I hit 8,000. So got over 1,000 subs in the 5 weeks I was gone. So that is incredible. So thank you everybody that is new to the channel. That is honestly amazing. I never thought I would ever get to where I am now, like a full 9,000. So here's to 10,000. And I'm thinking, ooh, there's something up here. Oh, oops. I didn't mean to do that. I'm thinking I'm gonna do some special thing, not sure what yet, when I get to 10,000. So if you've got any suggestions on what to do for 10,000 subs, then leave a comment below and let me know. Right, let's just carry on grabbing all of these bits. So I want to try and just get a few boxes built up. I do need rope for a box though. Did I throw away some rope? Oh, throw it into here? No. Okay, are there any other AI people? I don't think there is, so we might have to go out to another zone in order to get a bit of rope. But I'm going to leave these hares hopping around. I like them. And I'm going to leave that plant as well. Right, so what else can I make at the moment? A garden bed. That'll be good. Ah, I haven't got enough points. And I haven't got enough. Oh, I've got 1 point, so I can learn a club. Yeah, let's do that. And let's make up a few of these. Perfect. Right, let's drop off these bits. Awesome. I think we should head out. I'm going to go and have another quick look at what's in this box over here, see if there's any rope in here for us. Oh, there is rope. Okay. And water. You know what? Drink a bit of water now. Let's get this rope and I'll build it when I get back. Let's just go and explore the map. So there is one really cool thing I like about this map. Well, there's more than one. There's lots of cool things I like about the map. But there's these locations, the buffalo pastures, whatever you want to call it. They're amazing. Each buffalo, they're pretty easy to kill, and the buffalo give 2 hide and 2 meat each, which is really useful. And there's not that many enemies there, and they're, yeah, as I said, relatively easy to kill. So there's this entire bottom section of the map, which is currently not accessible. What you have to do is repair the broken bridge, but that requires tar, which is currently not in the game. I was speaking to one of the devs, and the dev said that they are currently working on building the area where you'll get tar. Ooh, what is this? Outlaw's camp. Okay, cool. Oh, this is disappointed. When I was on my other account, because obviously I've lost my account, there was a base up here called Reinhardt. Aww, I'm disappointed. Okay, so, hey, what else was it? What is that place? Ghost Town. Ah, right, I'm too far to the side. Here we go. Block Snow Passage. So you can currently get to the north, and you have to take about 6 iron pickaxes, and you break apart all the rocks here, and then you can get through into this area. And that's where you can see, like, maple trees, which I believe is the equivalent of oak. There's an outlaw's camp. There's a rock plateau and an Indian tribe. But something weird though. This one. You have to have a horse to get there. For the horse, you need your stable. So we are going to be working towards that. But for now, I think we should go to... Should we try a yellow zone? Let's give it a go. Let's see how badly this goes. One moment. Okay, I'm back. So I was just tabbing over to Discord to check what was going on. And that was my knuckles clicking. What are you doing, little hopper? So my bunny is currently running in circles around my feet. She always does that when I'm sitting at my desk. I love it. Right. So we are getting pretty close to leveling up again. Oh, here we go. This is a tramp, so I believe they're fast biter equivalent. And hey, he's giving us some rope. That is nice of him. And we've got another tramp with a knife. Die. Oh, I haven't set up custom commands. Okay. Let's set that to work like that. There we go. Oops. Okay. Oh, none of that actually showed up on the screen for you. Okay, on my end, there's a massive overlay on the screen, giving me a bunch of different options. There we go. And I wonder what loot we're going to get. I don't think I ever went to a yellow zone before. Hey, we got another club. And some fishies and a lamp. Oh, I wish I could go to the saloon, I think he said there. So, I believe this is the yellow forest that I went to. Pretty sure it is, at least. Hey, so we've got another two chests over here. Just seeing if we can get any good bits of loot. Oh, here we go. Got some shoes. Pocket watch. Alright, I don't think the ring, well, either of the rings or the pocket watch have any use at all. So, I'm going to leave them there for now. Now I'm just going to go back to killing stuff. Oh, I can put another level into my spirit skill. Here we go. Yes. So, two spirit skills currently. Two spirit points, sorry. So once we get that up to 5, we're going to be able to start claiming random coyotes. But I think you find them mostly in the stone zones, not the forest zones. Can't say for sure though, because I'm not entirely sure. Okay, so I've run out of space for pine logs. Let's just go around murdering everything. Oh, cool. I love the little just enhancement things they've added to the map. Like this lovely little old signpost here. It's so cool. Right, let's just murderize everything. Oh no, he broke up. Our knife broke. Right. Okay, so the wooden club is not that good. 14 damage and a relatively slow attack rate. Okay. But to be fair, it does only cost 3 wood to craft. What's going to be our next weapon? I think wooden spear. Ooh, that's expensive. 5 pine boards, 2 leather belts. Then after that, we get a shovel. That's not too bad, I guess. Oh dear. Okay, I need to be careful. Yep, he can hit me from miles away. This isn't good. Is that another one? Okay. Right. I think the goon is actually stuck on a rock. If you look on my map, you can see him pointing towards me. Right. Let's see if we can get this. Here we go. Yay, 28. Okay, so sneak attack is double, not triple. Good to know. The attack speed is so low. It's painful. Hit faster, please. Hit faster. Oh, dear. Right, hey, and more loot. Oh, look at that cute little hair just kind of obscured by my body there. Ooh, hang on. We've got an iron ingot here. And some full water jars, you know what? Let's drink them. Is there any... No, there's nothing I can free up in my inventory. You know, I don't think these watches are going to be... Oh, dear. Oh, we got an AI player and a goon thing. Okay. I don't think this is going to end well. And we got the goon as well. It's fine. I'm going to lead him away. Get him quite far away from the goon and then start smashing him again. One thing that's amazing, you heal over time when you eat, unless you use something like a bandage. So it actually works to spam your healing items. Nope. Can't be dealing with those goon guys at the moment. He's just too powerful for me. Right, so what have I got in my inventory? Okay. What I might do is, I'm going to run over to the other zone in the area. I believe it's, what is it? It's a yellow stone zone. Ooh, and there's an AI base here. It'll take 22 energy to get to. Or we could just, you know what? Let's just look around at the stone plateau. Don't be bothering for AI bases until I've got, I'd say maybe the next backpack. When do I get that? Cloth backpack. Here we go. Okay, so that's gonna be a while. That's level 30. However, one cool thing. The free crate, the mystery box, has a chance of giving you the best backpack in the game. So what I'm actually gonna do, I'm gonna open this now and I'll cut back after the advert's played. And I'm back. Unfortunately, this time I only got a single coin, which is disappointing. Yeah, if you look here, there is loads of different things you can buy. One thing I don't like, it doesn't make it clear if you get everything that's here, or you just get one item. Random equipment for the lone journeyman shows you all of this. Yeah, so it doesn't say if you get all of that. Same for this one. Although, wait. So for £1.79, you have a chance of just getting a single hat. Wow. But yeah, I'm not going to buy any packs, at least until I have some clarification on what they give. Just want to make sure. Right then. Okay, so I haven't got inventory space, but I can sneak up on things and attack them. Good, this isn't a goon here. So I think, yeah, what I'm mainly doing at the moment is just trying to level up a bit. Oh dear, something coming at me. Oh, cool. We've got a player here with... his weapon broke. I'm better than you. Although, looks like my weapon's about to break as well. But, unlike him, I have spares. Hey, so I think when I kill him... Hey, he leveled up. Ooh, look at that. He was carrying two bandages for me. Heals 30 health instantly. I think I might scrap one of these clubs for the bandages. And then... let's take the metal rings. I don't know what they'll be used for, but it could be something useful. Oh, sorry, sorry, Ragamuffin. The music for this game, it is oddly soothing and calming. It's just perfectly able to chill out and relax listening to it. Okay, let's drink this up. You know what, let's just keep murdering. Gonna need to level up. What I'm probably gonna do is a lot of farming off camera and see what I can get done. Or I might even stream this game at some point. Well, I definitely will stream this game at some point, but I might stream it sooner rather than later. Not gonna be, there won't be any streams or anything on the 22nd, as that is Kira's birthday. So I'm gonna be spending the day with her, of course. Right, and beard. Right, so we've got a few more chests here, but there are quite a lot of AIs in this zone. And at the moment, I can't tell if any of them are the goon people or not. Okay, we've got... Oh, okay, this is just two coyotes here. Let's take that. Let's eat a fishy. Oh, we are actually out of healing stuff now. I could put that there, but I would rather not use the bandages because I can't even make bandages at the moment. I feel so sorry for them. Their bodies go flying when I hit them. Maybe I shouldn't hit them. Yeah, so bandages do recover the health instantly. It's just so satisfying to whack them. I don't know why, it just is. I enjoy hitting them. That makes me a horrible person, I know. Ah, here we go. Let's take the berries instead, and let's see what shoes are better health. These ones are. Perfect. Right, one other thing I've noticed. The zones in this game are massive. Wait, look at it. This is a lot bigger than a yellow zone is in Last Day. I like it. And another thing they've done, they've added in a lot of mythological things, so that at the moment, I know of one, which is called the Wendigo. Which is a... I can't remember for the life of me. Someone told me about this earlier. I'm not going to try and say what it's from because then I'll sound like an idiot when I get it wrong. But it's a mythology for this time. And it's a giant creature thing that you can't kill but you have to chase away with light and fire. And then you can kill it. But it spits at you like a toxic spitter and regenerates health instantly. Unless you have a torch out. Okay. Now, are there any more nasties to kill? Here we go. So we are... Ah, nice. We're already level 4.5, roughly. Look at that. Now, I think I am out of weapons. Okay, I'm just going to punch this guy, then. Oh, I do like these little fist fights. It's just so satisfying. I don't know what about it. It just is. You know what? I'm going to take your club. Right, now, I think there's a chance I've killed everything here. Nah, here we go. So I Is this trap guarding another box? Oh, I didn't realize how low my health was getting there. Oof, that got really dangerous. I'm actually going to use that bandage. What have we got here? Got a ragamuffin. Okay, we are going to have to leave after this because our health is just too low. Ah, we've already opened this one. Take the chain. Okay, and I think I should just flee because I'm going to die otherwise and that would suck. Nice calming music. Right, and let's run home. One weird thing. It seems that the energy usage is really extreme for the distance you travel. But I'd say that all three of these, how much is it going to be, 18 for all of them? Yes, 18 for all of them. I'd say it should be a bit less than that. And then we've got yellow forest for 28, yellow stone for 32. If you look at some of the further out places like this AI base, okay, that's horse required, that's not the point. Mountain plateau, that's also horse. Okay. It wasn't the other day. I just want to point that out. When I was playing this the other day, it took like 90 to get there. So they have changed it. Ah, and the town is going to be one of the first updates. They're adding in a big town, which will be cool. I'm looking forward to that. But mostly, I'm looking forward to getting a horse. I think a horse will be awesome. Right. I am home. Horsey! But we have to build the stable before we can claim the horsey. Which is unfortunate. Right, let's take all of this stuff. Drop that off, take that. Awesome. Right then. Oh, I wonder if these dead bodies are ever going to disappear. That'd be really grim if they don't. Okay, so I would like to make a garden bed. So 3 stone and 3 fiber. Let's take that. Let's take that and let's drop that off. Perfect. And let's plunk that down there. Excellent. And... nope, don't do that. We now have food under construction. So that's going to bake. So it's 1 for 1. So this will turn into 20 corn for us. Which is pretty good. Right, let's drop that off. Drop that off. Already up to 7 meat, 10 hide. Is there anything else that we can do at the moment? Alright, I haven't got enough points to get this. This is the radio. Allows you to communicate with the traders. Right, so the well we're going to be wanting to get. So this is all going to take a little bit of leveling up. So what I'm going to do is end off recording first episode here. And off camera, I'm going to try and grind up a couple levels. Let's see. What level is... okay, so we get clothes at level 10. I'm going to try and grind to level 10 and get all the resources and everything I need to build probably like the well, carpenter table, foundry, a couple of bonfires, etc. And I'll do that all on camera next time, as well as probably some other stuff as well. So thank you for watching, people, and goodbye. Ooh, I didn't know I could do this. Well, this is cool. I think it's the exact same emotes from last day. Yeah, it is. Wait, do we stay like this? Yes, we do. Goodbye, everybody.